favourite body in history as your buddy, who would it be and why?
James Bond. Sean, maybe Pierce?
I'd probably have to go for a woman.
A big, strong he-man type of person.
I'm still thinking!
Magnum.
Ursula Andress, because she dresses the part.
Although, Scott did a very good job.
My wife, providing she was blonde, still 21.
Probably not allowed to pick my wife, she wouldn't come scuba diving.
She's not only my wife, but also my best friend.
Well, I didn't want to say too much, but if it could be anyone I could choose, it would have to be that sexy, foxy chick, Christina Garrett.
In my mind this week.
Probably the rest, Katie. First jump, first dive, first bit of simulation.
That's got to be when Jude's bikini. Oh no, that didn't happen, did it? Sorry. Can we scrap that?
Moment that most sticks in my mind this week. Yes, no seasickness.
Pretty much in the moment. I passed my Nitrox exam, beating John and Patrick, considering.
It's got to be coming through the Dunraven, first wreck, coming out, seeing Trevor the Turtle there, that was awesome.
Just seeing it in its natural environment, just happily munching away.
Well, it's gotta be the sharks.
Well, it must be the sharks. Three sharks in one day.
That was absolutely amazing. Going through the wreck of the Dunraven.
And the Thistlegall wreck, fucking brilliant, super. What would it be, and why?
I'd be a shark, attack fishermen and German tourists. I hate both of them.
It's got to be the whale shark, because they're big, like me, but they're graceful and beautiful, which I'd like to be.
Don't know much about sea creatures, certainly not their mating habits.
They're all so beautiful, it's hard to decide which one to be.
So I'd probably be plain, simple, and go for a scorpion fish.
I think I'd probably like to have the movement of a dolphin.
It seems to have a restful life.
Because it surfaces and it swims underwater with such ease, and they look beautiful.
Hammerhead shark.
But I would like the colouring of pretty fish down below.
I mean, where else can you look like a complete freak and no one's got the balls to tell you about it?
Be a dolphin shape, swim like a dolphin, but I would have the front end looking like the sweet lips, a yellow sweet lip with all the pretty black dots, and then halfway down my body I would go to a beautiful turquoise blue like the blue fusilier.
Fish you've ever seen?
Oh.
Oh, shit, what was it? The fish, that is the maddest.
Maddish.
Just imagine the maddest fish you've ever seen. It's most. But it has a good smile on his face. And he's the maddest fish, but the nicest fish. And that is Francis.
To play the lyric, she is a dancing queen.
Thank you. tomorrow.
In a way, it might make me appreciate even more just what a great time we've had out here.
Is it really over?
What is now?
It's fantastic. Week. Thank you very much.
It's been brilliant, and it's such a shame it's over.
Unbelievable experience, once in a lifetime.
Two qualifications to send it off when I get back home to Paddy.
Fantastic diving.
Good instructors, good food.
I'd like to thank everybody, the organisers, trainers. I'd thank Chris for bringing up your blow-up lip chart.
And I'd like to thank you all for your patience in instructing me.
Learned a lot, really enjoyed it.
Superb instruction, great evenings, a lot of humour. Thoroughly enjoyed it. Thank you.
Anything to show about you.
It's a living thing.
It's been fantastic, the boat, the diving, the whole team, and particularly the guides and instructors have done us proud, and hopefully
right,
we'll be here again.
Tell us what you're looking for.
I haven't got any crazy words. Great trip.
Land score, guy. Cut.
Question number four.
What are your nicknames and why?
What are your nicknames and why? Well, I'll you start with it.
Woody. Why wouldn't he? Would he always?
That's not really the reason.
Wouldn't you? Wouldn't you? I would.
You got the nickname Woody because your second name is Woods.
I know, but
it's not particularly exciting. I don't have a nickname.